Okay, I'm really excited because we just got our 23andMe results back, and Joanna's actually gonna walk us through the results. Joanna, what do we do first?
Well, let's go and log in, and then we get to choose to look at health results first or ancestry results. And I typically like to look at someone's ancestry results first because that really gives us some context for the rest.
Okay, let's go do that.
Okay, Joanna, I just pulled up the page.
Right. Okay, so the first thing we do, Matt, is sign in here if you want to click
okay.
up here.
All right, let me put in my login information.
Yep, great. And there are a bunch of options for where to start here, but I suggest we start with Ancestry Overview. And
okay.
I suggest we the most broad overview of your ancestry is in this feature called Ancestry Composition. And we already can tell from this that about a quarter of your ancestry traces back to Britain and Ireland.
Oh, great. So we'll click right here
yep.
then.
Yep. And this is what we call a ring chart. This is Matt Cook's ring chart. And let's get a little more detail by clicking the plus sign there. And if you click it one more time, that's when we get down to the level of Britain and Ireland. The one quarter British and Irish is indicated by that blue ring there.
Mm-hmm.
So overall, your ancestry traces to Northern Europe, just like me.
Okay.
And if you look, that's where most of your ancestry traces to, close to 98% traces to Northern Europe. And nothing, I don't see anything tracing to Southern Europe. But one curious thing, if you click right here on Sub-Saharan Africa, there's just less than 1% of your ancestry traces back to Africa. And that what I want to do is look at where on your genome that segment that traces back to Africa is. So
okay.
we're now looking at, this is the ring chart view. Let's go and change from the map view
okay.
to the chromosome view.
Chromosome view?
Yes.
Oh, wow.
And so we see that if we look at chromosomes, so each of these pairs of bars is a pair of chromosomes, and we've heard throughout the course about pairs of chromosomes coming from mother and father. So that's what we're looking at here. We start with the longest chromosome, number one.
Mm-hmm.
Number two is next, and we go all the way down to chromosome 22, and then the X chromosome here is here.
And I only have one.
You only have one, which is indicative of you being male, which I think you are
I already knew that. That's good.
But it's always nice when your DNA results are consistent with something you already know. That
sure.
just is kind of a check. It's something we actually check. We ask all the customers to tell us if they're male or female, and then we look at their DNA to see mm-hmm. if it's confirmed. That just helps us know that these really are your data.
Great.
And what I was curious about was this red strip here. So what we can see, most of those bars, the chromosomes, are a shade of blue, mm-hmm. and that indicates ancestry from Europe.
Mm-hmm.
Or Britain and Ireland. Now, but there's some other colors here, and the red refers to sub-Saharan African ancestry. Which of the chromosomes seems to have at least a segment tracing back to Africa?